इन क्लास 12 वी आर सॉल्विंग सम क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू पेडिग्री एनालिसिस। सो वन क्वेश्चन, लेट ऑब्जर्व द पेडिग्री चार्ट एंड आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस। ऑब्जर्व द पेडिग्री चार्ट एंड आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन। One pedigree chart is made here and here one pedigree chart and this is a female and two males, this one male, two male and one is the female. These are the offsprings produced and they married together and by the marriage they producing two offsprings. One is female and other is male. And here this is diseased. This person is diseased and offsprings. Here one female is diseased and one male is diseased. So what questions we have to answer? Identify identify whether the trait is sex linked or autosomal. It is sex linked or autosomal. Give an example of a disease in human beings which shows such a pattern of the inheritance. So here this sex is here, it is a sex linked. Answer will be here, it is a sex linked. The trait is sex linked. It is sex linked. You know here males and females are there. It be studied. It is male and the female is there and the offspring. This character is transferred from the here from the males. So male transferred from here and females are affected here, and here from the females it is transmitted and the males are affected here. So this trait is the sex linked. And next part, give an example of disease in human beings which shows such a pattern of the inheritance. So this is as the other examples are hemophilia. Examples, hemophilia, hemophilia, color blindness, comment. These are the examples of inheritance of such traits. These are also hemophilia and color blindness. These are the sex linked. So this is the one, and we can see another examples. We can see another example, and here one more diagram is given. One more pedigree we can study. another. This is one is male and he marry with the female, and in the F1 generation five offsprings are the produced. Five offsprings are produced. Here one is female, this is male, male is the affected, and next individual is also a male, it is normal, and you see here this is the female, it is also normal or the carrier, and this is female, and this female marry with a normal man, and offsprings produced are this is female, and this one is the male, and this is the female. So three are there, and here it one is semi with a normal man, the offsprings produced here, this one is normal man and other is normal, it is diseased man. So the question, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and here 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. You study the pedigree. What written here? Hemophilia is a sex-linked inheritance condition in humans, where a simple cut causes non-stop bleeding. Study the pedigree. Study the pedigree chart showing the inheritance of hemophilia in a family. Answer the questions that follow. You have to answer what questions are there. The gift. Give the reasons which explain the hemophilia. First, sex linked and caused by X linked genes. So here first it is sex linked. Why it is sex linked? Because it transferred from the unaffected carrier mother to the offsprings. This is carrier mother, and from the carrier mothers is transferred into the offsprings. So here if you want, you can study in such a way as from the rough. You can see here this is the male, maybe normal, and females maybe are diseased. So here X and X will be there, and here X Y will be there, X X and X Y. Here you know this is the, this is carrier, C is carrier, and this is the, this person will be affected. So here this is the affected. Fifth number is the affected, son is there. So here 50% sons are the affected, while the 50% son are the normal. You see here, and in case of the females, 50% are the carriers and 50% are the normal. So you see here this, if you see here in this case, this will also be carrier. Same situation is this is carrier and this is normal. And again transmitted of disease takes place only in case of the males.
So in this way, it is called as the sex-linked because it shows transmission from the unaffected carrier female to the some of the male progeny.
This is the unaffected
because the transmission of the disease takes place from the unaffected carrier mother to male offspring. And next question. Caused by X-linked gene because
this case actually this gene is found on the X chromosome and it females works as the carriers and it is more frequent in case of the male because they have only one X chromosomes.
So next question, because this is question number second, we have to study. Now next, now more question is there. A cross between a normal couple resulted in a son who was hemophilic and a normal daughter. In course of time, when the daughter was married to a normal man, to their surprise, the grandson was also hemophilic. Represent this cross in the form of pedigree chart, give the genotypes of the daughters and her husband, and give the genotypes of her daughter and her husband. Write the conclusion you draw the inheritance pattern of this disease. A cross between a normal couple resulted in a son who was hemophilic. So in this way, it was a cross was made in between the female and was the male, and son who was the hemophilic. So the offsprings which are the produced here. So this is female and this is male, and female work here as the carrier. It works here as the carrier. So X, C and the X. So hemophilia, so we can write at the H, hemophilic. And resulted in son who was hemophilic, and this is son who was hemophilic and normal daughter and a normal daughter. One daughter is supposed, one daughter produced, and daughter was the normal daughter. In course of the time, daughter was married to a normal man. She married to a normal man to surprise the grandson was also hemophilic. So what grandson was produced, and this son was also the hemophilic. This son was the hemophilic. So we can write it in this form. How? We can write a genotype since it is
males and here X, Y, the genes with having these genes. You can study in such a way, in the rough you can study in a such way as here X and X and X and Y. So here X, there will be and X, X and X, H and the Y. And and here X and the Y. So you see here 50% of the males and 50% females will be of the carrier. So C will be X and X will be there, and Mary Vika normal man, so he will be such type. And here their genotype will be XH and it will be Y. Such type genotype will be there. So in this way represent, once again listen you, a cross between a normal couple resulted in a son who was hemophilic and a normal daughter. So hemophilic son and a normal daughter. In course of time, when the daughter was married to a normal man, this daughter was married to a normal man, to their surprise, the grandson was also hemophilic. This is grandson and he was the hemophilic. So you have to answer, represent this cross in the form of a pedigree chart. Give the genotype of the daughters and then the husband. So this is the genotype of the daughter and this is genotype of her husband. Next, write the conclusion you drawn of the inheritance pattern of this disease. So this is a disease, is the sex link. This is sex link recessive. Here disease is sex linked recessive pattern of inheritance. So this is, so why it is the recessive? Because it is not found in this generation. If it skip this generation, then that disease is the recessive. So here in this generation, the disease was not seen. Disease was not seen in this generation. Only genes were present in the female that worked as the carrier. So this is the sex linked and the recessive. Why did this sex link? Because your female, for here the disease transferred from the mother to the of siblings. So here only males are affected here. So next we can study one more. Pedigree. So here one more question we have to see. Hemophilia is a six-linked recessive. No. One more question we can see. Hemophilia is a sex-linked recessive disorder in human. So one pedigree chart is given here. Male and female, and here they producing the offsprings. How many offsprings are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 offsprings are there. This is 5 offsprings are there. First one the female. This one is the male. Female, male, and other male. This is also a female and one female. She married with a normal man. As the result, she producing 3 offsprings. One is normal daughter, one is the affected son, and another affected, another normal daughter, and she marry with a normal man. And here this normal female, this marry with the normal man, and the offsprings, 2 offsprings are produced, 2 male offsprings are produced, and 1 male offspring, sorry, it is normal, and while other male is, offspring is the diseased. So we can write here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. 14 and 15. So, give all the possible genotypes of number 4, 5 and 6 in pedigree chart. Genotypes of 4, 5 and 6. 4, 5 and 6. You see here, this is the 4. In case of the genotype, genotype of 4, since this offspring is the disease, what is we are studying? This hemo, since 5th is hemophilic, so genotype of 4th, genotype 4th, so C will be carrier, so C will be X and XH. C will be carrier, so offspring will be hemophilic. Now next one is the 4, 5. Genotype of 5. What 5 will be there? 5 will have the X, Y and having the X hemophilic. Now next, and 6. In case of 6, 6 will be normal, so such type of the genotype will be there. Genotype of the 4, genotype 5, and genotype of the 6 will be there. And next, a blood test shown that individual 14 is a carrier of hemophilia. 14 is a carrier of hemophilia. What is the possibility that their first child will be a hemophilic male? What is the first possibility that their first child will be hemophilic male? So asking that the 14 number is married 14 number, so is the probability that the number 15 has recently married the number 14. What is the possibility that their first child will be hemophilic male? So in this situation, since this C may be carrier, C will be carrier since this is a disease, so C may be carrier. So in this situation, we can see here, this is the
C will be X, H and X and so male will be X and Y. In this way we can say that this will be X, H and X, X and X, X, H and the Y and X, Y. So here possibilities of the male child will be of the hemophilic will be of the possibility of the 50%, because 50% of the male child will be hemophilic and the 50% may be normal. So here the possibilities will be of the 25%. Next question, possibility will be of the 25%. 25% possibilities may be there. The question was, what is the possibility that their first child will be a hemophilic male? So in this situation, possibilities will be of the 25%, because the 25% of the 25% of the male, 50% of the male and 50% of the females are produced. So here 50% of the male will be of the normal and 50% will be of the hemophilic, and while the 50% of the females will be carrier and 50% will be of the normal. So in this way possibilities will be of the 25%. So now we can see another question. One third question we can take.